This is a story called The Best Nest. Mr. Bird was happy. He was so happy he had to sing. And this was Mr. Bird's song. I love my house, I love my nest. In all the world, my nest is best. Then Mrs. Bird came out of the house. It's not the best nest, she said. I'm tired of this old place, said Mrs. Bird. I hate it. Let's look for a new place right now. So they left the old place to look for a new one. This place looks nice, said Mr. Bird, as they flew up to a hole near a tree. Let's move in here. But someone else had already moved in, as a large raccoon popped his head out. So they looked at another house. This one looks nice, said Mr. Bird, as they popped their head inside an old boot they found. And there's nobody in it. You're wrong, said Mrs. Bird. This house belongs to a foot, as a large foot pushed its way in the boot. So they went on looking. I like this one, said Mr. Bird. It has a pretty red flag on the roof. I've always wanted a house with a flag, said Mrs. Bird, as they looked inside the mailbox. Maybe this place will be all right. But it was not all right. I guess I made a mistake, said Mr. Bird, as the mailman shoved a load of letters inside it. You make too many mistakes, said Mrs. Bird. I'm going to pick the next one. And here it is, right here, as they flew up towards a church steeple that had a hole in the side of it. They flew in. They looked around. Isn't it too big? Asked Mr. Bird. I like this place, said Mrs. Bird. This is the place to build our new nest. They went right to work. They needed many things to build their nest. First they got some hay. Then they got some solar straws and some broom straws. Then they got some jumper string. Then they got some sock string. And mattress stuffing. They got some horse hair. They even got some man hair. Soon they had all the hay, all the straw, all the string, all the stuffing, all the horse hair, and all the man hair they could carry. They took it back to build their nest. Mr. and Mrs. Bird worked very hard. It took them all the rest of the morning to finish their nest. Once it was done, Mrs. Bird said, this nest is really the best. I want to stay here forever. Mr. Bird was very happy too. He flew to the top of his house. He sang his song again. I love our house. I love our nest. In all the world, our nest is best. He was so busy singing though, he didn't see Mr. Parker walking up the drive to the church. Every day at 12 o'clock, Mr. Parker came to the church. Mr. Parker came to pull a rope. That rope went right up to the bird's nest. The rope was attached to a big bell right under Mrs. Bird's new nest. And as he pulled it, bong, bong, bong. Mrs. Bird flew out of there as fast as she could fly. When Mr. Bird came in, all he could see was a mess of hay and string and stuffing and horse hair and man hair and straws. No Mrs. Bird. Where was Mrs. Bird? I will look for her until I find her, said Mr. Bird. He looked high. He looked low. He looked everywhere. He looked down inside the chimney, but Mrs. Bird wasn't there. He looked inside a water barrel, but Mrs. Bird wasn't there. Then he saw a big fat cat, and there was a big fat smile on the fat cat's face. There were some pretty brown feathers near the fat cat's mouth. Mr. Bird began to cry. Oh dear, he cried. This big fat cat has eaten Mrs. Bird. Mr. Bird flew off. I'll never see Mrs. Bird again, he cried. And it became dark and it began to rain. It rained harder and harder. Mr. Bird couldn't see where he was going. Crash! Mr. Bird had flown straight into something. It was his old house. That old house that Mrs. Bird didn't like. I'll go inside, Mr. Bird said. I'll rest here until it stops raining. Mr. Bird went in, and there was Mrs. Bird, sitting there, singing. I love my house, I love my nest, in all the world, this nest is best. You? Here? Said Mr. Bird. I thought you hated this old nest. Mrs. Bird smiled. I used to hate it, she said. But a mother bird can change her mind. You see, there's no nest like an old nest for a brand new bird, she said, as she got up and showed Mr. Bird the egg she'd been sitting on. And when the egg popped open, the new bird thought so too. The end.